We are now getting very close to the moment we hold on to as the great blessed hope, and in Him stand as bold, appearing at the throne of grace, and stand before the Son of God as He does plead our case and validate our cause. By the rules and regulations according to God's law, in accordance with God's purpose as to His legal clause, that any who trust in His Son or that walk in His way will find that they are forgiven iniquity that day. The time and moment of His great graceful consummation, revealing of the sons of God and His Spirit nation. The time when His kingdom and reign will be made manifest and taken back from the rebels that put God to the test, that have tempted and tested God like only fools would do, to test His word's veracity, reiterate askew. They will discover way too late how serious this is, the temptation of the Father and the Son that is His. It is not wise to challenge the one true living God, for there is no escape for them when He is pushed to wrath. Those that have stood before the throne and yet have Him defied will find themselves in dire straits with nowhere left to hide. His mercy does last forever, this for the merciful. Yet the wicked, unforgiving, will them soon get their fall. Taste of judgment and His vengeance for evil defiance, thinking they could do their own will, in themselves reliance. Surely their moment of judgment is ready to unfold the fullness of iniquity which Abraham was told. The Amorites' iniquity first would be let to fill the cup of their full wickedness, that God would wait until the last piece of his evidence would then be put in place. Against emboldened wicked ones that stand against his face, those that have dared to challenge God and fallen from his grace, of his unto outer darkness will fully give them chase. We now are getting oh so close to the moment we hold out as the blessed hope, counted worthy then to be bold and stand before the throne of grace as our Lord will then plead our case for us as advocate, for in him all